Jesus keeps us near the cross.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
That's kind of our theme song here for a while now.
Amen.
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 Since we have a 12-foot cross on the top of the building, Jesus keeps us near.
Yes,
sir. Amen.
Thank you.
Near the cross. And I don't know no other place I'd rather be.
Amen.
Than near the cross.
Amen.
It was at the cross where I first saw the light.
Amen.
Now I want him and the sins of my heart rolled away.
Yes.
Amen. It was at the cross where I found Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And I'm happy now every day of my life because Jesus is where we need to be. Isn't that right? We need to be near Jesus.
Amen.
Most of all, we need Jesus to be near us.
Amen.
Amen. Good morning, Macedonia.
Good morning.
It's good to be here.
Yes.
Amen. On this Independence Day.
Yeah.
Amen. Both of July.
Yeah.
Amen. I know what we normally do on this day, but we in house in the house of God.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
We're going to celebrate Jesus.
Yeah.
Whilst we're here.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. First of all, to our honored deacons this morning. Deacon Wives, to Deacon Williams this morning, who have come, and his wife, who have come and shared with us this morning.
Amen.
The parents of Reverend John Williams.
Amen. Amen.
Come to be with us.
Amen.
Glad to have you here with us. Amen. The book of John, chapter 9. 1. And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, "Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus asked him and said, "Neither has this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him."
All right.
He said, "I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no man can work. And as long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world." That is the reading of our word this morning. We'll be dealing with much more of it down the road, but we're going to stop right there. And I want to use for subject this morning, why do we work? Why do we work? And the answer to that is to glorify our Father, which is in heaven. Why do we work? Why do we do the thing that we do? To show the power of God.
All right.
To show the Lord that is in you.
All right.
To show that God is in you.
Yeah.
A lot of times people ask you, why do you go to church? Why do you do the things that you do for the church?
Right.
Why do you work? And I don't know about your answer, but my answer is to glorify God.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
How many times, my brothers and sisters, have you done something lately just to show folks that you're God's child?
All right.
Amen?
Yeah.
This is something that's needed in the world today. We talk about it in our Sunday school. If we are a child of God, then we ought to show who we are by the work that we do. It's easy, my brothers and sisters, to sit around and do nothing and blame it on everybody else.
All right.
But if we're working for the Lord, we do stuff just for God. We don't do stuff to show how big we are. We don't do anything to show how much money we got, or how well we're living, or how what our society has lifted us to. But we do things just to show that we are a child of God. And I don't know about you, I'm not working for the accolades down here.
Amen.
I've been able, God has blessed me to be able to do just about most of the things that I wanted to do here.
Yeah.
He's allowed me to live just about the best that I can. So what I'm working for now is I'm working for my next home.
All right.
You see, I want to make the way paved for where I'm on my way to.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes,
it ain't a whole lot more, Ted, that I can do down here. But see, I got another whole life waiting on me on the other side. And when you ask me, why do you do what you do? I'm doing it now because God says I got to get ready down here.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, I heard the old folks used to say that this is the the dressing up room.
Come on.
Down here, say you got to go to heaven from right down here.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, I don't know about y'all. I don't know about what your plans are for life, but my plan is to live the best that I can. And to give the best that I can. And to help all along the way. And what God does for one, he'll do for the other. Because I read, my brothers and sisters, where it said there's going to be some books over. When we get back.
Yeah.
And one is that your name has been signed. Have your name been signed?
Yeah.
Amen. I stopped by to let you know that it ain't going to get signed just because you sit in church on Sunday morning. It ain't going to get signed just because you give $2-3 every now and then. It ain't going to get signed because you look so good. It ain't going to get signed because you wear a brand new suit every Sunday morning. It ain't going to get signed because you're driving a BMW. It ain't going to get signed because you're living in the high society, but it's going to get signed according to God's will and the work that you're doing down here. My brothers and sisters, in this passage of scripture, this man was born blind. But the word said he was born blind so that the power of God could be shown unto him. Can I get a witness here? There's a whole lot of things happening in our life right here today. It's happening to show God's power right here on earth. That's folks being healed. Not because of that goodness, but to show God's power. Jesus said, I must work the work of him that sent me. Because he said, I am the light of the world. And I believe he said that same thing about you. And if he said the same thing about you, then what we ought to be doing is we ought to be doing what the Lord is doing. Then he said that you are the light of the world. Y'all ain't helping me. Didn't he say you were the salt of the earth? You'll sprinkle a little every now and then. If you salt, you ought to make something around you salty. With the word of God. I tell them sometimes you ought to just go around just sprinkling. Every now and then you ought to just sprinkle the word of God on somebody so they'll feel what you feel. And see what you. If you say you are happy in Jesus Christ, you ought to make somebody else happy. In Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters, in this passage of scripture, the blind man. A blind man sitting by the side of the road. A blind man sitting there, he doesn't ask for anything. Matter of fact, he doesn't ask to see, even though he'd never seen in his life. And Jesus was just passing by. And he saw him. Ain't it good that Jesus will just pass by somewhere? And he'll see you. I'm glad he saw me. You ought to be glad he saw you too. So he was just passing by and he saw the man. I'm glad that God is just so good that he'll stop every now and then and just put a blessing on you. You ain't thinking about nothing. You ain't doing nothing. You just going about your own business. But every now and then, God will just lay a blessing.
Yes, sir.
I see he ain't never blessed y'all.
Come on.
But he done blessed me.
Yes, sir.
Can I go back and tell him this? Right out here on 315 a few months ago, standing out there in the hot, in the heat, and Jesus saw me.
Right. Right. Yeah.
And you say, I'm going to stop by and bless old Hudson this evening. Wasn't thinking about nothing. Wasn't doing nothing, but just doing the job. And Jesus stopped by. Right. And he said, bless Hudson. Oh, they bought Brian and gave me a handful of money. Right. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. Ain't the Lord all right? Yeah. Jesus will stop by your house. Yeah. Oh, he'll bless you. If you're doing what the Lord said for you to do, God will bless you. He sees you when you're right, and he sees you when you're wrong. And sometimes it seems like we are more right or wrong, more wrong than right. Ain't the Lord all right? God is a good God, and he's worthy. But he said a blind man will not ask him for anything. His disciple asked him, saying, Master, who did sin? The man or his parents? That he was born blind. Jesus answered them, neither sin, neither him or his parents. But that the works of God should be manifest in him. My brothers and sisters, manifest is to make clear or obvious to the eyes and the minds about the power of Jesus. If you're wondering about how God's power is, you ought to look at Jesus every now and then. Jesus went on to say, I must work the works of him that sent me. While it's day. Because night is coming when no man can work. Jesus said, as long as I'm in the world, I am the light of the world. I don't know about you, but I can testify that I am the light of the world. And God is shining his light on me. And if I am a child of God, I will be able to shine my light on somebody else. They thought that some disease, tragedy, or unconfessed sin had gotten into the man's life. You know how it is when folks see you doing bad? They swear that you done something wrong. Stay sick for a little while and they'll go around talking about, oh, I sure don't know what he done wrong, but he done something wrong. God got it in for him. I dare you to look at Job. You ever read Job? The Bible said Job was a perfect and upright man. Says to me that you don't have to have done something wrong for God to put something on you. Amen. Amen. We was talking about Job a few days ago, and I asked the question that when your day come, will you be ready? Because you see, that day they said that the devil showed up at a meeting in heaven. And said, God asked him, why are you here? And he said, I'm going to and fro, up and down. Can't find nobody. So God, he had somebody picked out for him. Good God Almighty. And he was able to say, have you considered my servant, Job? I've been in Job's shoes. Because I've had some days when the devil just wouldn't leave me alone. I see y'all ain't had none of them days because you ain't saying nothing. But if you had some days where they left, the devil was all around your house. You ought to shout amen. And you ought to shout thank you, Jesus. Because you're still here. You see, I learned when the devil comes, he can't take you out. If God don't tell him, God told him, say, you can go down and do whatever you want to Job, but don't take him out. Don't leave. Don't take him Don't take it. Say, just mess with it. And I found out that he wanted him to mess with Job to see if Job would turn.
All right.
See, most of us, we are turning right quick.
Amen.
Don't let no trouble get in our way.
Amen.
We'll deny God, we'll turn back on this journey, we'll leave him by himself. But he said, you mess with Job and see what Job gonna do.
Amen.
Y'all know the story. They took everything from Job. But Job didn't turn. He stayed with the law.
Yes.
And I made up my mind, my brother and sister, no matter what happened in my life, I'm going to stay with the law.
Yes.
Because the law has stayed with me.
Right.
I've been around him for a long time. I've been through many ups and downs.
Yes.
But God hadn't left me yet.
Right.
And I don't believe that he's going to leave me.
Yeah.
Because you see, like Job, he got a hedge.
All right.
He got a hedge around.
Yeah.
But see, Job wasn't concerned about the hedge.
All right.
Because he told the law, said, "You take that hedge up around Job, I'll make him curse you to your face."
Yeah.
But I'm glad today that today, not my day.
Oh, yeah.
But when your day come, he might take the head out from around you.
Yeah.
And you might have to suffer the consequences
yeah.
Of what the devil has in store for you.
Yeah.
Ain't the law all right?
Yeah.
My brothers and sisters, the reason this message is important is because the question has been asked. My brothers and sisters, around me, how have you made it this far? And I said, I made it only by the grace of God. Jesus said he sinned, he didn't sin. And his parents didn't sin. But it was done just to glorify Jesus. And I tell Macedonia all the time that I'm here only just to glorify the Lord. I've had enough stuff to take me out of here.
Yeah.
I've been on my sick bed and I could have been dead and gone. But God let me live to tell you that I live to glorify Jesus.
Yeah.
Big glory.
Yeah.
In other words, my brothers and sisters, Jesus, my brothers and sisters, just felt like making a miracle that day.
Yeah.
He stopped by just to make a miracle that day. Jesus reminded them that as long as I'm in the world, I am the light of the world.
Yeah.
You see, my brothers and sisters, I've been blind, but now I see.
Yeah.
And it's only by the grace of God.
Yeah.
And I stopped by this morning. I got some more blind folk in here.
Yeah.
You've been blind, but now you can see.
Yeah.
You've been lost. Yeah. See, I ain't no sinner in here with me. You've been lost, but now you're found.
Yeah.
Ain't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
And that's because of his amazing grace.
Yeah.
My brothers and sisters, church is where you need to be.
Yeah.
When God's got a blessing
yeah.
waiting on.
Yeah.
That's why I sing some time past midnight.
Yeah.
Oh, gentle Savior, hear my humble cry.
Yeah.
While on others,
yeah.
thou art called. Do not pass me by. God might have a blessing waiting on you. Every now and then God tell him, do not pass me by. My brothers and sisters, passing by every now and then, God will just drop something on you. If you're in the right place at the right time.
Yeah.
Ain't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
God is a good God.
Yeah.
Take a look at this miracle. Mm-hmm. My brothers and sisters, the blind man sitting by the road.
Yeah.
And what Jesus will do sometimes is he'll use some other agents to help him along the way.
Yeah.
The blind man was blind. Mm-hmm. Jesus just decided to help him.
Mm-hmm.
Look at what Jesus did. He said, spit on the ground.
Yeah.
How would you like to have been standing somewhere blind and somebody walk up to you and spit on the ground?
Mm-hmm. Ain't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
You see, but God will do something sometimes to let you know that he got all power. The Bible said he spit on the ground and he made a ball of clay.
Yeah.
And he anointed the man's eyes.
Yeah.
But he still couldn't see.
Yeah.
And he spoke a word to the man.
Yeah.
He said, what do you see? He said, I see men.
Yeah.
But they look like trees.
Yeah.
But at least he could see.
Yeah.
Ain't the Lord right?
Yeah.
It's something when you've been blind all your life.
Yeah.
And now you're looking up because somebody done spit in your eye.
Yeah.
Ain't the Lord right?
Yeah.
He said, I'm blind, but I can see men that look like trees.
Yeah.
He said, now, what I want you to do, he said, I want you to go out to the pool of Siloam.
All right.
And wash.
Yeah.
You see, every now and then for us to get better, we got to do something for ourselves.
Yeah.
We sit around and we wait on the Lord to do something.
Yeah.
But every now and then we'll have to do something for ourselves.
Yeah.
He let us get in the mix of it. You see, he had to go out to the pool of Siloam and wash.
Yeah.
Ain't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
And I don't know about you, but he said when he came back, he came back singing.
Yeah.
My brothers and sisters, Jesus made the blind man participate in his own miracle.
Yeah.
Every now and then you got to participate in your own miracle.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can just do what the Lord said for you to do.
Yeah.
And everything will work out while you've been trying to work it out.
Yeah.
God has already worked it out.
Yeah.
But every now and then he'll tell you, I want you to do this thing. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, you got to do something for yourself. Ain't the Lord all right?
Yeah.
I get confused sometimes
uh-huh.
when I hear folks that are sick on their bed and the doctor will tell them to get up and walk.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all don't know nothing about that. Pain is racking all through your body. Doctor say you got to get up and walk. I told him, doctor, I can't walk.
Yeah.
He said, Hudson, you got to get up. And walk. Sometimes you got to participate in getting well for yourself. Keep on setting that. And ain't doing nothing for yourself. You'll be sitting there until they roll you out on one of them long beds. And the Lord, every now and then, you ought to just do something for yourself. You ought to try and give God the glory while you try. I don't know about you, but you said, help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. I'll be all right. So I got up and I went to walk it. And I told God, if you hold my hand, I'm going to keep on walking. Walk with me while I'm on this teacher's journey. Jesus to walk with me. Do you need him to walk with you today? Anybody in here, have you ever went through anything and you called on the Lord? Seemed like he wasn't hearing your call, but you got up went down on your knees and you're calling one more time. And he said, get up, servant, and walk. Have you ever been down to your last dime? Didn't know where your money was coming from. And the Lord told you, you need to get up. Get off of Social Security. Get off of the government. Stop looking for your stimulus check. And go back to work and walk. Anybody walking? And the Lord, all right. I believe God. Do you believe him? Won't he do it for you? And the Lord, all right. He made eyes, see. He made legs, walk. He made tongues, talk. And he, all right. He got folks up that was on their deathbed. And he made them walk. I'm walking because Jesus is standing by my side. As long as I'm in the world, I am the light of the world. And I'm going to tell you that Jesus has got all power in his hand. Do you know he got all power? He got loving power. He's got walking power. And the Lord, all right, and I heard somewhere what Jesus said, I am all that you need. He said, I am the bread of life. And the Lord, all right, he said, I am the good shepherd. And the Lord, all right, he said, I am the resurrection and the life. And the Lord, all right, he said, I am the true vine. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man coming to hear me except by God. And the Lord, all right, let me back that up. He said, no man coming to God but by me. And the Lord, all right, have you tried him? Do you know he's all right? I learned a lot from his head. He'll be your best friend. And I know he loved me. How you know he loved me, Hudson? Cause one Friday, on a hill called Calvary, he died. Didn't he die? He died. He died for you. And he died for me. But he didn't stay there. Cause I heard the record say, all right.
a way maker.
Thank you, God.
He's all right.
Thank you, God.
He's all right.
Jesus.
He's all right.
Yes.
Heal the blind man.
Yes.
Sitting by the side of the road.
Yes.
Wasn't asking for nothing. Mm-hmm. He just decided he wanted to do a miracle.
Yeah.
That's a powerful statement.
Yes.
Y'all might not know it. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we'd be sitting doing our own business.
Yes, Lord.
God said, let me hold out here and bless you. Jesus.
Yes. Thank you, God.
And he did it not for himself.
Amen.
Not to prove that he had power.
Yes, sir.
But to glorify
his
Father.
Yes,
which is in heaven.
Yes, yes.
I hope you take that with you. What you do for others, don't look for no credit.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Don't look for somebody to pat you on the back.
Right. Right.
Don't look for them to call your name.
Right.
Folk get mad when they done something and you don't call their name. But don't look for them to call your name.
Yeah.
Because guess what?
Nope.
My Father knows. You don't have to tell nobody what you've done.
No.
I get sick when I hear folks say, well, I did this for so and so and so. And I did that for so and so and so. If you did it, keep your mouth shut. Because you did it and God ain't going to bless you for it. Or you did it for the wrong reason. You did it so you could be spoken good of.
That's right.
Wrong reason.
But did it to glorify your Father, which is in heaven. Ain't the Lord all right?
Yes.
Ain't he all right?
Amen.
I got excited when I was writing this, how the Lord would just every now and then stop and just decide I'm going to do something for somebody that didn't ask me. He got folk asking him to do stuff all the time.
All right.
But this man didn't ask him to do nothing.
Amen.
He said, I'm just blessing.
Right.
And the good part of that, when Jesus left him, he told him, they asked him, is this the man that was bone blind? He said, yes, it's me. So how did you get healed? He said, that man called Jesus.
All right, now.
Stop by.
Yes.
The roadside.
Woo!
Woo!
All right. Awesome.
And he opened my blind eyes.
Amen.
Your eyes been open.
Yes,
have you told anybody about it?
Jesus.
Y'all ain't told nobody. Have you told anybody? You'll be able to tell somebody, but it wasn't nobody but Jesus.
Amen. Nobody. Thank you.
Jesus made a way.
Yes.
Out of no way.
Thank you.
Ain't the Lord all right?
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Go to the church, Lord. Go to the church. I love you.
Look at somebody and tell them that you love them. Amen.